might be in a very different position, considering that we talked about he hasn't given agency in previous compositions, previous rosters. Let's highlight quickly Lucas on the Rakan. So great little detail right now. IG getting ready to go on the bottom lane. That's a Gravitum. The flash away won't save him, as down at the bottom lane, Puff's going to be the focus. It's Ignite down and first blood. Over to Xiaoyu,
IG. But IG taking it away from them.
Yeah, Sonic Wave's going to come through. Remember, there's a smite here. Fringe is going to be a little bit late as Kamtang
drives. Where if Shun can hover around the spot side, as we see both junglers here now.
It's a baby's at half health. The 80 carry of IG needs to get out of there, but Xiaoyu goes down.
Bottom lane gets here in time to where IG can try to force some kind of winning fight off of this, but it seems like so much time wasted when you could have been pushing your bottom tower.
Well, Nani's going to at least run in anyway. Frigid gets the Herald with a kick back as well, gets him out. There's the ulti, a two-man fear from Yuekai. It's beautiful, but follow-up necessary as the quickness comes in. Frigid goes down. One for the hair as well. We're not to unleash teleport. That's the other big, big lyric. Yes, TP to a turret. So
we can already see them trying to set up a potential top dive onto new. A pause.
Good work, though. Get it. Kick into the wall. Sonic Wave. That's clean. No Hextech Ultimate for you as the teleport finally comes through. It ain't unleashed, so Captain only had one choice. Sonic Wave doesn't connect. They need to work behind. There's the ulti. Oh my god, it hits. Yuekai take people with him as well. New lyric. Going to open up the bottom side of the map for Dragon coming up while TT decide the trade-off for the next Herald.
I mean, you even
put it in the inventory as well. Looks like we've got Crit Corky coming out while Nani, he has a teleport available, Lyric, but he's going to get the turret in the meantime. Herald placed into the mid lane. A lot happening with the map state as this Dragon sits waiting.
Yeah, but still, look at your minimap. Yuekai is roaming over. The TP coming out from Nani now. IG want to fight.
Oh, Lucas got the ulti as well. There's Shadow goes right on in for a two-man gloom. That's a reset. Long distance onto Captain almost for another. But a two-man grabs a multi. Pause. Only one. Puff gets flashed on as well. Xiaoyu and G. That's the IG spirit we know and love. With three members instantly dead from TT. No, I was right. It's four with Yuekai carrying on this Vex.
And I really like the setup coming out from IG. They got the vision from the prior play, had the ward set up for the TP flanks. We see Yuekai give the bottom wave early so it can start to roam, so we can guarantee that they have numbers advantage, and IG just completely clap them. They're gonna steal away camps, they're gonna get another turret on top of it, and now this gold lead is
on their vision phenomenally.
They pretty much had the map covered this whole game, and now for IG, they're just covering Nani as he pushes outsides, because no neutral objective up on the map right now. Q-tier pushed so far into their base, it's really hard to find kills unless they go forward.
Well, it's a wild growth for Shun going in for the Sonic Wave.
I was gonna say, like, we are so far beyond the point of TT being able to think about side lanes. Both their side lanes are losing so heavily. They can't win against either Gwen or Vex. I guess Camille, as we can see, can fare against Vex, but still, have to be incredibly careful.
Dragon going to be picked up. The easiest Ocean Soul I think we've all seen.
I have them in playoffs in my power rank. Because I think I did. I think I was crazy enough to believe in IG for no reason, to where you can break down one of these turrets.
Looks so difficult at this point. I want to put a side note in. I forgot one player in Ning, but now in the top side, Yuekai on top of you once again. That was the Shadow Surge. And now the cooldown's down. Gives some opportunity for TT, but how much of an opportunity are we talking about with the top lane inhibitor dropping alongside the turret? IG with this Ocean Song, healing it all back. Lucas has been syncing up with his jungler once again. We talked about him having the highest jungle proximity out of any support last year. And for Invictus Gaming, you know, once again, those two linking up, great synergy with the rest of the team, is bringing on this game number one winners. There's the ulti again from Yuekai. Underneath turret, there's some good damage coming out of TT, but look at the response. Yuekai hits Captain once, and he's near half HP. He's into the back line. The kick before the polymorph. And Xiaoyu picks up yet another kill on Southwind. Shun is frontlining this. The ultimate misses. Xiaoyu getting close, but it might not matter in the end. Baron coming through. They have the Ocean Soul again. It's a Lee Sin who still hasn't died. One Nexus turret hits its maker. And IG staring at the other. Yuekai still in here with Flash available, waiting for that Doom to come through. Personal space to give a shield, but doesn't need it for now. Gets it, sends them backwards, and TT lose yet another. This is tough. Dropping to the Nexus, and IG are in for the win. As against TT, they tried their heart out in the early game, but Invictus Gaming pulled off fights like no other. The Nexus will drop down in game one, a sure thing for the new Invictus Gaming.
IG, gotta pad stats when you can.
It was that game number one where we saw TT kind of flatline from the mid-game onwards. Can he bring a better performance this time around, Lyric? Because their composition,
bit of scale.
Ignore what I was just saying, Nyu is as well. Nani's in a lot of trouble as the ulti hits as well. It's doom and gloom time, immediate burst.
Nani might make his way down mid to finish getting the first spin, but we have a dragon, Scott.
Great sonic wave, it's only level 5, it's not stolen, but Xiaoyuan, both summoners down in the interim. Shun in the middle of the pit, and he has to flash too, but one more burns, all it's going to take. Puff is given a lantern. That's a strong bottom 2v2, is helped out by Frigid. Flashes burn in every corner, and Puff gets that Gravitum down. Look at the Severum Crescendum. He's building up more damage.
It's going to be a 4v2 play.
Captain has
IG in a pretty rough spot. Frigid doesn't ult.
Again, once again, the fear through. A great kick back right into the waiting arms of Vex. And you know what? You're as sad as her right now if you're the IG bottom lane. Well, remember, we saw a couple of kills go down, and then TT kind of fell to the wayside, but this is momentum that continues going, as I love the word momentum today, apparently, and Nani loves to take this 1v1, but it's not fair. IG brought the cavalry up here as Nyu gets the big hand of it, the zap back in, but hang on, Gwen does so much work. Nani lucky to be alive after snip snip time, and IG now with the Herald Lyric, this is their response.
Yeah, IG realizing that TT's bot lane would be looking for some recalls of their own, just send their bot lane straight top to look to make this play. They're going to be able to break this one down with Rift Herald while Nani goes and answers on the opposite side. I don't think
TT... have what looks like a Gordrick here, Lyric. I tell you what, this is pretty exciting to look at. Trying to guess the items here. Is the bottom lane dive, is it even going to be that? The ignite, the flash away. He survives. He's ticking down. That's a long ignite, but Southwind
in as well. TT exert their pressure, set up for this turret. They're going to be matching that first turret blood that was picked up by IG moments ago. So
how they plan on dropping down this Rift Herald.
Yep.
With the fact that they are losing push to Uokai, I feel like you just look to use it on side, because you should never have an opportunity to roam mid and drop it there. So I think TT also making the correct response.
All right, well, they're going to get the turret for now without it anyway, but... yeah, Shell behind their first turret in the mid lane. Uekai holding off on this LeBlanc pick that has been banned for a reason. Even the ulti misses from Captain. The explosion begins. Uekai showcasing his LeBlanc in a massive way. No one dare stands near him.
Just looking to find something. This will be IG's second dragon, so we'll have this win condition to fall back on top. Uekai to keep splitting, getting vision down on that top side and kind of looking for these picks. And heck, you even have dragons on your side. It's Pop!
Oh, that's just
the ultimate. Has the Calibrum there as well, so doesn't have to commit too deep and is able to pick up the kill. But okay. Southwind
on the other hand, maybe not the same, but Puff, remember, he was the Giga Chad once before, as into the front line. Shun's going to get absolutely blasted. Super Mega Death Rocket, and look at the wild growth. You can see Xiaoyuan Jing quite low, gets hit with the Infernal on the back end. Even Captain helping with that. I'm not sure.
If he could have found Puff there, that would have been so massive. Puff, though, still half HP. And the Jace just completely deletes him.
Forget it. Who are we looking at? Uekai to find Puff. Instead, it is Nani who comes through. Now, Lyric once again. As the dragon goes down, as IG go to soul point. Burst potential.
Puff having pretty good guns for this. And most importantly, Frigid is set up on the flank.
Frigid's on the flank, but if Baron keeps going down, remember that TT won't have a smite nearby. Sonic Wave doesn't connect, and Uekai now spotted out. Southwind getting Giga low as well. You burst it down. Super Mega Death Rocket does so much, and onto Frigid. He's gone in when the team's been absolutely destroyed. Southwind is a freebie at this point, and Invictus Gaming running at TT because they mean business, but the ulti is a four-man, five-man fear. Invictus Gaming, if they had no one else that they killed, TT could have capitalized. But it's over. IG on the Baron and TT. What a captain in earlier.
That was just so unfortunate for TT. Even going all the way back to the setup. IG, though, coming out strong. Get an ace. Pick up a bit.
And now, what is it? Five? Almost 6,000 gold ahead, Lyric, if I could tell. A really good start to the split for Invictus Gaming. Despite the early game in this game, they've come back and... you know, you and I were...
with all these champions coming out strong, whichever team can stack up more range, I feel like you just have so many options in terms of how you are able to play out around these dragons, getting first control and first movement out of mid, especially when you combine it with what IG have in terms of also having side lanes. And it's not even surprising anymore, Asterix. They have Infernal Soul. He's already massive. This is just how it's going to happen.
You know what? At some point, the child on the ice rink, Lyric, they get off because they're sick of falling down. And for TT, today is not the day. They're going to get off. They're going to take their boots off, sit down in front of the couch and go, where did it all go wrong? As the Shadow Surge misses through, Captain will get a response. But Uekai is in the back line dealing so much work. TT on the fountain, scared of life. And this Jinx now getting some revenge for that mid-game play. TT, I'm sorry it's not your day, but for Invictus Gaming, they open their spring split with such a big bang.
Hello everyone, welcome to Interview, and now we have invited Xun from IG with us. So congratulations on this 2-0 victory. Let's talk a bit more about the game one, because game one you got the MVP and you controlled all the Drakes. You got the Dragon Soul in the 23rd minutes, and you guys were able to just snowballing so well. So tell us more about the early game strategy in game one. 那首先恭喜勋也取得了一个开门红，然后呢，说到你们第一局，勋也拿到了MVP嘛，而且感觉到你在控龙啊，包括说滚雪球都做得非常好，23分钟就拿到了龙魂，所以想问一下，第一局可能你们前期的布置是怎么样的呢？就我们前期的话，因为我们当时阵容就打团也比较厉害嘛，然后加上前期拿了龙之后，就节奏会特别快。
I think based on our draft in game one, we were able to have a very good team fight composition, and also in our after we have gotten a few Drakes, it feels like we really can be able to have a very good snowboard. So because of that, we were able to have very smooth early game. Yeah, game one was a perfect game from IG, and let's talk a bit more about game two, because game two in the early game, the opponent's team, they actually got a huge lead. So what's the team's communication in the mid game, and also what's your focus in the mid game in order to make such a perfect turnover or comeback. 那其实到第二局，我们感觉 TT 好像在前期占据了一些优势嘛。但是虽说我们也比较好奇，可能对于 IG 对于你们来讲，你们中期的一些交流，包括说一些关注的重点会是什么呢？能够最后很好的打赢一波翻盘。就当时因为我们破格打会好一点嘛，因为他们当时是冲的嘛，我们拉扯的话就自然而然就很好赢下比赛。
So in the mid game, we try to focusing on the poking because the opponent's team, they have a very engaging compositions. So if we just try to kite the opponents a bit, I think it will be easier for us to win the team fight and also make a comeback. And also my last question is, I've realized that in this new roster from IG, you guys have many rookie players. So tell us more about the synergy at this moment and what's your goal or what's the goal from this IG? 那最后一个问题也想问一下，其实这个赛季 IG
也会有很多新人选手的登场吗？所以说也想问一下，可能从我们的新的角度看一下，现在队伍的一个配合是怎么样的呢？同时，你们队内有没有什么一个目标呢？关于这个赛季的，就我们现在配合，因为大家都是新人嘛，就慢慢的一起共同进步成长，然后争取一下每场比赛。目标的话就还没有，就先进季后赛吧。
Because there are so many rookies in our team, so we would like to make some growth or development in every single matchups and try our best to win every single game, definitely. And for the goals, to be honest, we don't have like so many goals, or maybe we would like to get into the playoffs. And also, thank you for the sharing and congratulations on today's win. 那再次恭喜你们，也希望也能如你所说，后面也都能赢下来. And back to you guys. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Thank you to Wendy and Xun. It's good to hear from Xun, especially since he is that strong member we talked about. Goals towards playoffs, Lyric. I mean, a lot of teams are going to be saying that. They're going to aim their goals high, but I think reasonably for IG, if we consider how they play today and how we can expect them to play, there is a chance that IG could be a lot better than I personally thought and rank them at the start of the split.
Oh, I definitely think that they are a team that it's possible to achieve playoffs, right? Whether they're favored or not, I think a lot of people probably not going to lean that way, but competing with the expected mid-tier teams seems like OMG, yeah. I think very doable. So gonna be nice to see how they do. And MVP is obvious, Hysterics. You can take it away, but we all know who it is.
Bring out Uekai, the LeBlanc pick, Lyric. I mean, why does it synergize so well with him? Why is it his favorite? Well, because of that. This was such a clean game, and it wasn't the game where we're like, hey, he's picking up every single kill on the board. He was exerting so much pressure and following in the footsteps of the old IG mid laner. And